Skinny.
Listen, Kenny, I had a problem down there. Well, actually, I did. My sister-in-law had a problem with a refrigerator freezer she bought from y'all.
Okay.
She's pretty upset. Her name's Merva Jean Wexler. I don't know whether you remember or not. She bought a big, I don't know, 20, 30-foot refrigerator freezer about 6 months ago.
Wexler?
Wexler, yeah.
How you spell it?
W-X-L-E-R. Listen, the reason I was calling is that her husband, my brother-in-law, Cooter Bob Wexler, they is trying to have him a child there.
Okay.
And it ain't funny.
Too funny?
No, sir, it ain't funny because Bob passed away.
Bob Wexler?
Yes, sir. Before they could have a kid.
Uh-huh.
And they's trying, of course, and they's having to do it by artificial persemination there. And he, before he passed on, he filled about a half a quart jar, empty mayonnaise jar of his seed there. It was up in the freezer. And she just got back this morning. She went to Branson with her Sunday school class.
Mm-hmm.
And that daggone thing quit working. And it thawed out and spoiled his seed there. And that, she's tore up. She's been over here crying all morning long.
And where does she live?
She lives here in Quinter.
And what's her address?
What difference does that make? What I'm calling about is the daggum seed that's got spoiled in there.
The what got spoiled?
The seed, his seed.
Oh, the seed?
Yes, sir. He's going to have a baby.
Good God, how long did that take save up?
You think it's pretty funny?
Well, I think
she was wanting this kid, and they ain't going to be able to have one now.
Just because he lost the seed.
Well, he's passed on, Kenny. He dead.
He died, and then he left the seed in the freezer.
Yes, he done it before he passed on. That's what the problem was.
I see.
He ain't there no more. And that's all we had of him left. What I need to get done is she's pretty upset. I was just wondering if we might just couldn't get some money out of you to compensate her, or maybe some, you know, appliances or something to take this woman off my hands, because she's crying and tore it up about it, and I ain't needing to handle it no more.
And she's your sister-in-law.
Sister-in-law, yes, sir.
Maybe I just thought I'd go talk to her.
No, sir, she's too tore up about it. She wanted me to call you, and I'm either going to have to get some satisfaction, or they're just going to boil down to an ass-whooping.
An
ass whooping. Now I'm getting ready to come over there and be on you like a rat on a Cheeto.
Who put you up to this?
It ain't funny.
Huh?
How about you just fill a mayonnaise jar out for me and I can put it in this place?
How long did it take me?
How long might that take? If she needs to get artificially perseminated, she's in heat.
Yeah,
I mean, I was going to tell her to adopt one of Randy and Peggy Cooks' kids, but I'd think they're all touched.
you guys,
we're glad you could have a good laugh today, Ken.
Who is Randy Cooksey?
Who is it?
Yeah.
It's my brother.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's the one that put all that stuff in the freezer, I think.
No, he's the one that took it out. He's the one that took it out and thought it was bacon dripping.
Oh, God. Oh, Lord.
What? He's going to season a pot of beans with it.